Okay, so you guys may recognize this pea hive, as I recently did a thermal scan of it to show you what the bee body temperature is when they're hanging on the outside of the hive. Well, what's happening here in my part of the northeastern United States is we're in a constant heat wave. And normally the bees are collected outside the hive, which is no big surprise. But I want you to notice something about these bees. They're not just hanging dormant the way those that are conserving energy do. There's lots of dancing going on up here, waggle dancing. And you'll also notice that across the surface of these bees, there's lots of movement. That's a problem because this colony is about to swarm. And today is September 25th, and it's too late in the year for a colony to swarm successfully and set themselves up somewhere else. We're coming near the end of our nectar flow, so something has to be done. You may have watched one of my videos in the past where I reached into a swarm that was on a tree branch and I collected the queen. By removing the queen, we returned the swarm to the colony that they came from, so we did not lose the bees. Now I want you to notice what's going on here at the landing board, and you're going to see that there's a lot of activity of bees that are leaving. There's also something else going on here, and that is the deployment of a large number of drones, which are the male bees. If you haven't seen them before, you'll notice they're much larger than the workers. They have large eyes, and the eyes come together without a gap at the top of their head, all so that they can see the queen. Look here on the landing board. They're coming out, and they're all taken to the air because they're going to meet with the queen as she leaves the hive. And they're excited because they think a replacement queen would be coming shortly after, and they want to be the ones to meet with her and to mate, of course. So also notice the fanning that's going on here. They're really getting the pheromone into the air. There's lots of activity, and all of these bees are getting worked up. So what can we do to stop the swarm? We know that 9 times out of 10, a swarm this late in the season is just not going to make it. So we have thousands of bees here that are basically doomed. So what would you do about it to stop this swarm? Now obviously it doesn't come through on YouTube, but you should just feel the breeze that's blowing out here. And notice that the workers that are up on the front are also waving. And remember, up above them is a huge collection of bees that are just ready to deploy to form that swarm. And here's a little drone that I picked up. And there's lots of activity up above. This is the bearding area. If you recall my more recent video just several days ago with the thermal test that I did, there are even more bees outside now than then. But I did bring that thermal camera along, and I'm going to show you what I got with it, what kind of temperatures we're dealing with. And this colony is actually sitting in the shade of a Colorado blue spruce tree. Here's that FLIR C2 camera, upper left there. It's 91.9 degrees in the center, but the temperature in some areas here is 99.5 degrees Fahrenheit, and you see the little hot spots of the bees moving around there. So a couple things are going on. This is a super loaded hive body. It's full of honey, it's full of resources, and the bee population is at a peak here. And this is up right underneath that telescoping cover. And just look at all the bees that are massed and waiting. So what could we do? We could wait and let the queen fly out, and I could make a video showing you that the swarm follows her and where they collect, and then we could hope to rehive them. But if we did that, we'd have to put them in a new box. I want to keep these bees right here, and I want to put them back inside this colony. I don't want to take the risk of losing so many worker bees. Here's another drone, of course. Drones can't sting, they can't bite. They just drink and lay around and wait for days like today when a queen's going to fly out in hopes that the replacement queens will soon be flying out as well. Now, the reason that these bees are active and going to swarm out is, again, kind of up in the air from time to time, but the temperatures, the fact that we have a nectar flow going on, even though we're coming to the end of it, the population of the hive is huge, so they are primed to swarm even though this is a bad time of year for them to do it. I have noticed in the past that when bees get prepared to swarm, if a rainstorm or the weather turns or something like that happens, they can change their minds and they can stay. So look, all of a sudden, magically, it's raining on this colony. Not really, of course. I've taken the garden hose and it's connected to a well. So the water that I'm sprinkling on the colony now is not chlorinated, it doesn't have anything in it, it's just regular groundwater. But by sprinkling lightly over the entire hive, notice what's happening with the activity of the bees that were clinging and waiting to depart with the swarm. All of that dancing activity has stopped. Plus, we're cooling them down. Remember, it was almost 100 degrees Fahrenheit with this colony, so they actually needed a cool down anyway. Does this water hurt them? Actually, no, because what's happening to them now is no different than if a normal rain cloud passed over and if we had a spot shower that occurred here. But what it did do is stop the dancing, stopped all the movement, and the bees that were flying out and waiting for the queen to fly out so they could congregate somewhere else have changed their minds, because look what else is interrupted. All the bees at the entrance that were fanning and spreading out the queen's pheromone, they've stopped. It's raining, as far as they know, and they've gone back inside the hive. Now, when they've done that, the activity and preparation for the queen's departure has all stopped. So the bees that were flying around in the air, and there are thousands of them, have all decided to return to the colony because the pheromone is now missing. What a difference. All the bees that are on the colony are now basically dormant. And they're much cooler. They're down in the low 80s now, where before they were at almost 100 degrees. I'm going to give you a side view here so you can see again. Look at all these airborne bees that were hovering in the air waiting for that departure, as I mentioned before. Now they're all coming back, and there's a big traffic jam on this landing board as they all move back inside the hive. Now, what will happen if the queen that's in there has changed her mind and decides to remain? Well, something has to change in this colony for that to occur. If, in fact, the frames were full and the queen has run out of space to lay eggs, for example, and this is a highly productive queen. I've done several splits from this colony this year, so she's an excellent queen, and I also want to make sure to keep her here. So we're going to have to do something different. We're going to have to either pull frames, which I don't want to do because the honey that they've stored is for them to winter over, but I can add already drawn comb and more medium supers on top in order to accommodate the surplus worker bees that are existing in this colony now. And I'm scanning along the side to show you, this is the top of the hive. Look at all the workers that have decided to remain in place because of this rainstorm that hit them. So all their plans have changed. But we're going to have to pull this hive apart, and I'm going to have to add resources. Now, if the queen stays and all these workers move inside, what happens to the developing queens that are in queen cells? Well, if the queen stays, the workers that are in this colony will turn on those cells, they will tear them open, and they will destroy the developing queens. Primarily, it's been my experience that the new queens don't hatch the same day or even before the old queen leaves. The swarm occurs several days before those hatches occur. So there is actually a lag time there where they would be queenless until the new ones hatch. So they will turn on those queens in their cells, chew them out and destroy them, and allow the old queen simply to remain. As you can see, there's a huge amount of bees here, and we just don't want to lose them. And of course, when they were flying off and getting sprinkled with the hose, they were landing all over me and landing on the camera. And here's one of the workers that's still kind of recovering here. Now here it is. You'll notice that the landing board is already dried off. Lots of dry bees on the surface. And if you recall before, there was a medium and this yellow was the top. And I've added this blue and red medium supers, as well as a top entry hole and this insulated cover, where before they had a metal capped wooden cover, which was very hot, and especially given the weather that we've had, and here it is on the ground. That cover is probably 30 years old, as it was given to me by someone a little over 10 years ago. But I've taken it off and leaned it against the cinder blocks here at the base of the colony, so the workers that were under it can of course migrate up and get back inside this colony. Now a few hours later, most of the front bees have migrated inside. My guess is that they're occupying these upper two empty medium supers that have frames in them which already have drawn out comb. That's important because they need a place to start putting their nectar right away. There isn't time this time of year to be putting empty frames or foundation and hoping that they'll draw out wax again. They don't have the time to draw out the comb, and if the queen can't find more places to lay, the workers may push her out again, and then of course we would lose these bees even later on. But things are promising now. It looks like they're going to stay, and they're all moving back in, and we'll watch this colony closely over the next few days just to make sure this expansion of the colony spaces was successful. And look already at the side. Remember, they were several inches thick, mass on the top of this yellow box, and now the majority of those have gone in. And this is a close-up of the entry, and look at all the bees that are migrating in from the surface here. So they have accepted the additional space inside, and that means fewer of them will be exposed to the high heat, and of course the colder temperatures at night. So hours from now, they cleared the face of this, and there was just a small collection, and again, a small beard of bees underneath that landing board. But it was a success. Of course, we have clear skies, and we have no rain. In fact, we don't have rain in the forecast for several days. So taking the hose, sprinkling the hive, resulted in saving the bees and keeping them in the colony where they're safe. Thank you for watching, and I hope you give me a thumbs up and see what we do next.